Hello everyone, welcome to my Dungeon Crawler series. This is a project I started for fun to try out an idea on stream, and I'm slowly turning into a small dungeon toolkit. You can follow the development of this game every Friday night during my weekly stream. Currently, I stream at 9 PM Australian Eastern Daylight Time. However, make sure you subscribe to my channel to be notified of changes to the schedule. I thought it would be a nice idea to do some code review videos on this project to explain the different techniques used here. In today's video, we will look at the logic we wrote to make an infinite procedurally generated dungeon. This is one of many different techniques to create dungeons. Here we randomly select new rooms to extend the dungeon with as we move through it. You can see the 16 different rooms the game currently has, but any number of rooms are possible. The only requirement for this logic is that they are all the same size. The rooms are grouped together in a single folder. We can have multiple folders for different sets of rooms, so we can create levels with a different look. There is an empty room scene that is part of our plugin. This room scene has a script in which we put shared logic and expose a few properties that we can set on each room. The ones important for today's video are the four tick boxes that identify which sides are open. When we then look at an actual room, we can see that the open sides match up with the properties, so we can build logic based on this. The map logic itself builds the map as we navigate through the world. Every time our character enters a room for the first time, we trigger the logic that extends the map. We check all adjacent tiles from this room to see if we need to add a room there. We see here that out of the 8 adjacent tiles, 3 are empty and need rooms. Starting with the one on the right, we first check each side to see if we have a passage there or not. We set bits to indicate this. 4 bits for openings, 4 bits for walls. If there is no tile to a side, then both open and wall bits will remain unset. Now we loop through all our rooms to find which rooms could potentially be used. We use the flags on our rooms to create the same set of bits for this room. Now we do a bitwise AND with the two sets of bits. If the outcome of this matches our first set, the room can be used. For this first room, it doesn't match and we discard it. The second room we're checking here does match and we can use it. We do this for all the rooms and then pick one at random from the valid list. When we look at our main character scene, at its root, this is a kinematic character with a collision shape. We have put the kinematic character into its own physics layer. All player-controlled characters are in the friendly layer. When we go back to our main room scene, we see that this scene has an area node called Player Detector. This area node has its physics mask set to the friendly layer and thus detects any player's physics bodies that enter it. All rooms are added to a maze node in our level. When a player character enters a room, the character enter room function is called on the script. In this script, we loop through an array with vectors that identify the 8 sides we need to check. We keep a dictionary with entries for each room we've added to our maze, so we check if a room exists. If not, we will choose a new room to add. First, we need to set the bits based on the passages we need for this new room. Again, we use a helper array with vectors for our left, top, right, and bottom rooms. Next, we loop through all available rooms. We get our open sides flags, inverse and shift that value so we add our wall flags, and perform our bitwise AND function to determine which rooms are usable. If a room is usable, I add it multiple times to our rooms that fit array. A room that should be rare is added once, so it is less likely to be selected. A room that should be common is added multiple times to increase the chance of it being selected. Finally, we pick a room at random and add it to our maze. And that, in a nutshell, is how our dungeon logic works. You can find the source code of our little project on my GitHub page. There is far more in this project already and will likely get much further ahead as time goes on, but I will keep making these shorter videos to explain individual concepts used within this game. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. It greatly supports the channel. If you want to support me more directly, please consider supporting me through Patreon. Links, as usual, can be found in the description below. Until next time!